Hello and welcome to Follow. And today we have with us one of the most versatile playback singers that we have in India today, Kavita ji. It's a pleasure having you on Follow.
Namaste. Nice to be with you all.
Not actively into playback, why not? I mean, shouldn't be any reason not to.
I think for some reason, the kind of singing has also changed now. And a lot of singers, songwriter kind of songs have come in now. And a lot of Western influence of songs with a guitar, and you know, you're singing like that, and and I think the most important thing is to have maybe an attitude or a texture of the voice. That's what they look into now. And also, to a certain extent, they really don't need singers who want to be strictly pitched all through, because now you have pitch correction machines. So maybe, I don't know, for that reason, it's possibly they don't feel the necessity for my kind of singing. I don't know what it is.
Something that Alka ji mentioned recently, see, like, aaj ka situation jo hai, I mean, a lot of, this is exactly what she said. Like, I would have died if someone else sings my song.
Yes, you sing and you go home and then the radio is somebody else. Now, for me to have such a negative opinion about myself, to feel that, oh, they really didn't like my song, they're not keeping it, and somebody who's just come into the film industry with hardly 1 year of experience, they found that song was better in her voice and they kept that, whereas me, after 40 years of singing, they couldn't retain my voice. It's a very, very hurting, insulting. And you know, it's let down for my own self.
Talking about commercial music, practically, there's something called what today is called item number, technically. Yeah. Back then it was not called item number, but nonetheless, it was still a special song in the film. And I think, I don't think it would be wrong to say, if from the late 80s to the 90s, you almost reigned out there in terms of those songs, from Hawa Hawaii to
Chuma Chuma and Tu Cheez Badi Hai Mast Mast, Mera Piya Ghar Aaya Ra, O Ram Ji.
I know. Of those songs.
Yeah, yeah, lot of this and wonderful songs I sang. And you know, Tu Cheez Badi Hai Mast Mast and songs like that, even Hawa Hawaii.
Yeah.
Looking back, I'll say it was really not an easy song to sing. Definitely not an easy song to sing for lots of reasons. That 6-7 minute songs had to be sung in a stretch. If you make a mistake, you redo the whole song. You can't sing one line.
Your most popular song? I mean, I can't pick any. So would you be?
I would still say Hawa Hawaii is probably the reaction from the audience after I sang it in 1986. After so many years, even now when I sing Hawa Hawaii on stage, I get the maximum response for that song.
You actually just talked about Lakshmikant Pyarelal.
Lakshmikant Pyarelal called me to dub songs. Dub songs in the sense, ultimately it would be sung by Lataji for the film, but they would need my voice for the actress to emote and shoot the song. So that time, Lakshmikant Pyarelal were the number one music director. So I used to sing at least 4 or 5 songs for Lataji a week, which was the first song of theirs which actually got kept, which was Kahe Ko Byahi Bides Lakhi Babul More, the last song on Rekha Ji. So that song got kept. Then Tumse Milgar got kept. So this way, slowly, slowly, certain songs of mine started being kept. And then Hawa Hawaii was supposed to be a dubbing, clearly enough. But I did my best, and it was only about a few months after that I got a call from Lakshmi Ji's house, saying his secretary Chandrakant calling me and saying, Lakshmi Ji, aapse baat karenge. लक्ष्मी जी केम ऑन द फोन ही सेइंग, बस आप मिठाई खिलाइए, मैं आपको खुशखबरी दे रहा हूँ कि हवा हवाई आपकी आवाज़ में रहने वाली है. आई सेड, आई वाज सो एक्सटैटिक. देन आई सेड, लक्ष्मी जी पर एक बात है, मुझे वापस गाना पड़ेगा. ही सेड, क्यों? ही सेड, मैंने एक वर्ड गलत गाया उसमें. ही सेड, गलत गाया. ही सेइंग, कविता जी ये तो गाना आप दोबारा वैसे गा ही नहीं सकेंगे, और गलत गाया या सही गाया, ये गाना ऐसा ही रहेगा.
ओके, बट द फिल्म फेयर अवार्ड दैट ही गॉट फॉर 1942, दैट वाज आल्सो RD's last music. How was the experience? I mean, if any word on RD Varman as a person?
You know, when I got my Filmfare, my knees were of course trembling, and when I walked up on stage, and I remember Vinod Khanna ji giving it to me, but there was a lot of sadness in our heart, because all the awards went to Love Story 1942, and Panchamda was not there to see the success. And it was specially important because a few years before that, Panchamda has just been seeing every film flopping, and he was a person with no major work in the industry. A man like him with no major work, and he gets this huge film which is going to be a huge success, and he doesn't live to see it.
Among the cliches of today's, among the new crop of composers and singers, anything that you say, anyone who's actually taken your attention or say, this is nice?
I won't say it is, it could be a particular song. it could be a particular song by a particular music director. Of course, people like Shankar Ehsaan, lawyer, are firmly established and they're good music directors. But sometimes, occasionally, let's say, like this time, I like Bajirao Mastani, and I thought Sanjay had made a great effort to keep classical music and the music of Maharashtra alive through his films, which is a good contribution, you know, today. So then there was a song called Chunar of Arijit, which I like this year. Chunar karke usne gana gaya. A nice, very, very, very sweet and very emotional, nice song. So once in a while, there are certain, one song of Jeet, Muskurane. I like Jeet's song also. So like that, there are certain songs which catches my attention. I won't say I like all the songs, because for me, sometimes they are very, very heavily programmed. And one more thing which really, really bothers me about singing today, which I wish they wouldn't, because if those singers have good textures, let them be natural, but to make them so auto-tuned.
Kavalishi, lastly, any message to your fans on follow?
First, let me thank you for having supported me for so many years. And still, for the younger generation to still have remembered some of my songs, I'm very, very grateful to that. And I'm grateful to God for having brought me into music, because all the best things that have happened to me in my life has been connected to music. And I would like to say that please keep the windows of your mind open and allow all different kinds of music to come into it, not only Bollywood, but our classical music, which is our very, very strong heritage for everything. The moment you learn to respect classical musicians and you play classical music in the morning in your house, on your speakers, you know, any rag of the day, instrumental, it need not be vocal. And just try this out for 1 month, that you have very soft classical music playing in the background in the morning when you get up, or the sounds of the tanpura. You will definitely slowly learn to lead a stress-free life, because there's no better friend than music, and it definitely de-stresses you.
Thank you so much, Regina. It's so beautiful. Thank you so much. Thank you for having us.
Thank you.